the story of St. George and the Dragon is one more example of an old, old human problem, feeding the monster. St. George's story with the dragon is actually based on human sacrifice, and a particular European version of human sacrifice, unlike, say, South American, Mesoamerican sacrifice, where children often were killed for ritual purposes. This is like the myths that go back to Theseus and the Minotaur, where there's a monster, sacrifices have to be made, and you bring the children there, you kind of shove them in, close the door, and you might hear the screams and the munching behind the curtain, but you don't think about it anymore. So those are the Western ways of telling the myth of feeding the monster. So in St. George, the version of it is that there's a dragon, and the dragon has to be fed. And so the community, the kingdom, starts giving them sheep, giving sheep to the dragon. The dragon gets sick of sheep and wants children. So they start giving children by lots, and eventually the lot falls to the daughter of the king, the princess. And she goes, and George appears on his horse and attacks the dragon before the dragon gets to eat the princess. But he doesn't actually kill the dragon. He subdues the dragon. Then he tells the princess to put a rope around the neck of the dragon and bring the dragon to the town to show the townspeople. She does that. She leads the dragon back into the town. And all the townspeople are, of course, terribly frightened. So what St. George does is then he steps in and says, well, if you'll all convert to Christianity, I will kill the dragon. And so they do, and even though the dragon's been being nice all this time, he comes in and takes his sword and whacks off the dragon's head. So we can see that this is an interesting version of this whole story, because it's not just a hero rescuing people from the monster, but it's also about this kind of subjugation and conversion that happens all at the same time. And it's really interesting that St. George becomes the patron saint of England in that sense, because he ends up representing these people who go out, they subdue the heathen and convert them, and they often have spectacular deaths as a functional way of convincing everybody to convert. So there's a long history there that St. George is connected to.